the heart of New York's posh Central Park South, across the street from Bolivar Plaza, among the rich and elite at New York's athletic club, the governor of Puerto Rico, Luis Fortuño, hosts a fundraiser to benefit his political interests, charging $1,000 per plate, while an estimated 50% of his constituents live below the poverty line, while also seeing his support from leaders of the Tea Party grow. These same supporters and lobbyists have aided in Fortuño's systematic mortgaging of the island of Puerto Rico and subsequent privatization of schools, parks, natural gas lines, and even the airport. The following videos confirm that the promotion of Fortuño has been calculated and deliberate.
And as in any other state in the country, we have serious problems with our infrastructure. Our roads, our bridges, airports, ports, and what have you. And I feel very strongly that there's no reason why we need to invest government money to develop further those programs or projects. Thus, we approve the most advanced public-private partnership program in the country. And we have, as we speak, a program, not just one project, but a program whereby, as we speak, we have schools that are being modernized or built and will be maintained, that will be handled by the private sector, roads and highways, water, energy projects on our main airport as well. And we have a number of other projects that will be joining that program. Again, that's just a summary of what we have been doing and accomplishing in the last 23 months. The recession commenced here 2 full years before it started in the rest of the country. So we're coming from way behind most other states.
Protesters braved the elements and gathered across the street from the New York Athletic Club on Central Park South, denouncing the acts of Fortuño, while speaking with the voice which, in Puerto Rico, is met with physical resistance and violence from police. Their gathering was met to present disapproval of the governor's motives and deception to the public's view. The irony of the location of these meetings didn't go unnoticed by the protesters, as they were held across the street from Bolivar Plaza, being viewed by the frowning statues of the three Latin American liberators, Simón Bolívar, José Martí, and José San Martín. This fundraiser will aid in pushing an agenda whose main purpose is to lease our home to private corporations.
We're here because the governor of Puerto Rico, Luis Fortuño, is across the street collecting $1,000 from the banks and the corporate interests that are slowly but surely trying to buy off Puerto Rico, buy chunks and parcels of Puerto Rico away from the people of Puerto Rico. We're talking about the privatization of public lands, privatization of public agencies, and we're here as human beings, as Puerto Ricans, as New Yorkers, who are indignant with the policies and practices of a governor that we see as corrupt, of a governor that we see in bed with Wall Street, of a governor who personifies everything that's wrong with the governor of Wisconsin, for instance. Before Scott Walker of Wisconsin, we had Luis Fortuño in Puerto Rico doing exactly the same thing that Scott Walker's trying to pull off in Wisconsin, that Chris Christie's trying to do in New Jersey, and that we've got a bunch of other governors that are looking at this example of Luis Fortuño as what they want back in the United States. The most extreme, right-wing, Republican, conservative, Tea Party-loving John Birch Hill membership SOBs that we have in politics today. They're destroying the environment, they're destroying collective bargaining, they're destroying labor rights, they want to make it hard for poor people and poor students to attend public universities, they want to privatize and put charter schools all over the island. And we're talking about 4 million people, 50% of which live below the poverty line. And this is a governor who also wants to put a gasoducto, or gasoduct, from the southern part of Puerto Rico to San Juan. A pipeline that's gonna go straight through the heart of Puerto Rico, and it's gonna destroy thousands of acres and destroy the quality of life of thousands of people there. And now we've seen what a natural disaster could do in a place like Japan. God forbid a natural disaster like an earthquake or a hurricane affect Puerto Rico and there's a gas pipeline like that. We're only 100 miles by 30 miles or so the island would be ruined instantaneously. There would be such a huge eruption or explosion that tens of thousands of people, if not millions, would be killed by such an explosion. So we know that this guy has no sense. We know he's greedy. We know that he's with a corrupt party, a statehood party. And they're in la-la land if they think that Puerto Rico will ever become a state, because they're catering to and they're appealing to the most right-wing, extremist, racist element in the Republican Party. They will never, absolutely never allow 4 million Spanish-speaking people of color into the United States.
Y prácticamente estamos aquí para denunciar el gobierno de Luis Fortuño, que viene a esta ciudad a recoger $1,000 en un partido político que busca la estabilidad para el país. Y viene a esta ciudad para promover su estilo de estrategia económica, una estrategia económica que prácticamente ha eliminado los servicios básicos del pueblo puertorriqueño. Estamos hablando de un país que prácticamente ha cesanteado a sobre 25,000 trabajadores, un país que tiene un alto por ciento de asesinatos, con más asesinatos que cualquier país latinoamericano. Estamos hablando de que en Puerto Rico matan cada 6 horas a una persona. Estamos hablando de que Puerto Rico poblacionalmente se está matando más que cualquier país latinoamericano, incluyendo México. Y estamos en una crisis social, un caos humano, donde ya no podemos parar más. Y desde Puerto Rico, como aquí en Nueva York, el pueblo más grande que tiene Puerto Rico en Estados Unidos, vamos a darle candela. Desde adentro y desde afuera vamos a seguir indignándonos con el gobierno de Luis Fortuño y con el estado colonial que mantiene la isla.
I've been working with Pedro and a lot of the people here with a group called New York on the UPR, and we've had some really wonderful events these past few weeks, and we've been able to pull this thing together in the last 24 hours, because that's what we found out about it, because we couldn't pass up an opportunity for the governor of Puerto Rico to know that he's not welcome in New York, he's not welcome in Puerto Rico, and he's not welcome wherever we have freedom-loving, human rights-loving, civil rights respecting human beings. He may be across the street with the bankers and the corporate interests, but he's never set foot in Alvario, and he never will because he's not welcome.
Voy a ser bien breve, gente, porque de verdad que está cayendo agua, está cayendo lluvia y está dando duro. Pero que quede claro, no pueden con el empuje. Vinimos hoy para dejarle un mensaje bien claro a estos jepulaquenitos de mierda y a este gobierno de mierda de mi país, que se cree que va a repartir la estrategia de crisis, de coloniaje por todos los Estados Unidos y por los países latinoamericanos. Y yo creo que el mensaje de aquí está bien claro. Con granizo, le venimos aquí a decir que este país se respeta. Y si allá en Puerto Rico hay un pueblo indignado, en Estados Unidos hay un pueblo, hay una diáspora bien indignada.
Y donde se pare se la montamos.
Ahí está. Donde se pare, le vamos a dar candela. Gracias.